Hello and welcome to this new lecture on internal combustion engines. In this lecture, we'll introduce some important parameters related to the engine geometry. So looking at the figure, we have the bar denoted by B. So B is called the bar, which refers to the diameter of the piston. And also the connecting rod here has a length equal to L. So L is the connecting rod length. The crankshaft arm has a length equal to A. So A is called the crankshaft radius. And the angle between this vertical line and the crankshaft arm position is called theta. So theta is the crank angle. Now obviously the piston will travel between two upper and lower limits, between the top dead center and the bottom dead center. So TDC is an abbreviation for the top dead center, and it refers to the crankshaft position at theta equal to 0 degrees. So when theta is equal to 0 degrees, the piston will be located at the top dead center. So this refers to the crankshaft at a position theta equal to 0 degrees. So when theta is equal to 0 degrees and the piston is located at the top dead center, the cylinder volume in this case will be this volume here, highlighted in blue, and will be the minimum volume. So the cylinder volume is minimum. And is also called the clearance volume. The clearance volume denoted by VC. Okay? So we say that the volume when the piston is located at the top dead center corresponds to the minimum volume and also corresponds to an angle theta equal to 0 degrees and is also called the clearance volume. Now when the piston reaches the bottom dead center, the crankshaft angle in this case will be equal to 180 degrees and this corresponds to the maximum cylinder volume. So when the piston reaches the bottom dead center, we have the maximum cylinder volume, which includes the volume displaced by the piston as it travels from TDC to BDC, plus the clearance volume. So the maximum volume will include the clearance volume plus the volume displaced by the piston as it travels from TDC to BDC. So BDC, we say, is an abbreviation for the bottom dead center, and it refers to the crankshaft at a position theta equal to 180 degrees. So in this case, the cylinder volume is maximum. The cylinder volume is maximum. So VBDC is the maximum volume and corresponds to an angle theta equal to 180 degrees and also is denoted by V1. So the distance, the linear distance between the TDC and the BDC is called the stroke S. So S is called the stroke and is the linear distance between TDC and BDC. And here you should know that the stroke S is related to the crankshaft arm length A, since when theta is equal to 0 degrees, we have this position of the crankshaft arm, And the piston in this case is located at the top dead center. So this length here is equal to A. Now when the crankshaft rotates half a rotation, it will reach this position also with a length equal to A. So during half a rotation, the piston will travel from the top dead center to the bottom dead center, and it will travel a distance equal to one stroke. So one stroke, as you can see, corresponds to a vertical distance completed by the crankshaft equal to 2A. So we can say that S is equal to 2A. Now, another important parameter related to engine geometry is called the compression ratio, R. So the compression ratio R is the ratio of maximum volume to minimum volume. So VBDC to VTDC. So we can say it is V1 divided by the clearance volume. Another parameter is the displacement volume, VD. So this is the volume displaced by the piston. So if you look at this figure, the volume displaced by the piston is this volume here. So this is VD, and it is equal to the maximum volume V1 minus the clearance volume VC. So VD is the difference between the maximum volume VBDC and VTDC, the minimum volume. So V1 minus the clearance volume. And also we can say that the displacement volume is equal to the volume of a cylinder having a length equal to one stroke and a diameter equal to the bore B. So we can say that VD is equal to pi over 4 B square S. So this is the displacement volume for one cylinder. However, let's say for multi-cylinder engines, so engines having multiple cylinders, the displacement volume in this case will be equal to the total number of cylinders multiplied by pi over 4 B square S. So for example, let's say we have 2-liter four-cylinder engine. In this case, the displacement volume for this engine will be equal to 2-liter. However, the displacement volume per one cylinder will be equal to 2 liters divided by 4 cylinders, which is equal to 0.5 liter. So each cylinder will have a displacement volume equal to 0.5 liter. Now, the last important parameter that we want to talk about is the mean piston speed, UP bar. So as the piston travels between TDC and BDC, its speed will change continuously. So for example, starting from TDC, the piston speed will be equal to zero. Then it will increase to reach a maximum at the mid position between TDC and BDC. Then it will decrease to reach a zero speed again at BDC. So the piston speed, as you can see, will change continuously as it travels between TDC and BDC. So we can say that there exists an average piston speed. And in order to calculate this average piston speed or this mean piston speed, let's say that during half a rotation, the piston will travel a distance equal to one stroke. However, during one complete rotation or one revolution, the piston will travel a distance equal to two strokes. So we say that the mean piston speed is equal to N. So N is the crankshaft speed measured in revolutions per second. So this is the number of revolutions per second, or we can abbreviate it as RPS. So RPS is the abbreviation of revolutions per second, multiplied by the distance traveled during one revolution. So the distance traveled by the piston during one revolution is equal to 2s, 2 times the stroke. So this is measured in meters per revolution, per one revolution. So we can simplify revolution with revolution, and we'll obtain a mean piston speed equal to 2ns. So that's it for this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll introduce other parameters related to engine performance, such as the power, the efficiency, and the torque. So see you in the next lecture.